Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I give you exposition of Matthew 10:1-22. And when he had called unto his 12 laborers, they were not disciples, they were laborers, he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Now there is 12, they were also doing the job of the John the Baptist or the rabbi. So they had in their training on this aspect, physical aspect. Then they were getting training in spiritual also from Christ Jesus to make them perfect. Now the names of the 12 laborers and not apostles as written in the Bible, they became apostles after the Pentecost. When they became apostles, they never baptized anyone in water. Are these the first Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James of son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas, and Matthew the publican, James the son of Alphaeus, and Lebbaeus, whose surname was Thaddeus. Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who also betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentile, because they are not spiritually sick people, and into the city of the Samaritans enter ye not, because both of them, they were not spiritually sick, they did not need doctor. So he was training them to become doctors. But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Here Christ Jesus wanted to stress that he came especially for the spiritually sick chosen people, which he addressed as his own, and the own did not respect him or honor him, and the own rather they killed him. And as you go, preach saying, the royal kingdom of God is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the leper, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely ye have received, freely ye give. So Jesus was not a hireling. He was the ambassador of our Father God. Provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purses. That don't carry any money. You can't worship mammon and God. So if you have carry money, then you might be attracted to make more money by giving sweet sugar-coated sermons. Nor scrip for your journey, neither two coats, neither shoes, nor yet staves, for the workman is worthy of his meat, of his labor. Remember, John the Baptist had zero dependence on mammon, and so the laborers of Christ Jesus should be not a hireling of mammon. The present priests in churches are the hirelings of mammon, capable of praising mammon only and not God. And into whatsoever city or town ye shall enter, inquire who in it is worthy. That we don't go into the house or somebody who is not worthy, who is not twice born. So a person who is worthy, clean-hearted and worthy, go and knock at his house, and there abide till ye go thence. In Jesus, you do not go into someone's house uninvited and stay for a while, little while. And when ye come into an house, salute it, wish them well. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. but if it be not worthy, let your peace return to you. Everyone reaps the fruit of his own conscience. So good conscience always bring good fruit. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your word, when ye depart out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet. That means if somebody doesn't honor you, so just leave them. As Jesus said, you are the salt, to his 12 laborers, he said, you are the salt of the earth. So people, if you meet who have no salt or conscience, just leave their house. As Jesus said, cast them out, those which, when the salt loses its saltiness. So you just leave that town, like Sodom and Gomorrah type town, if you come across. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. That means they are worse than the land of the Sodom and Gomorrah, which were known for not mercy. They were hostile to the stranger. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpent and harmless as dove. Remember that these temple priests, these priests in the churches, they are like wolves in sheep's clothing. And they will, when you preach the gospel, they don't like it, because you are praising God, they are used to praising Mammon. So they are wolves in the sheep clothing, and they might put their congregation after you, go and beat him or throw him out. But we beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will score you in the synagogues, and ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. So that means the Gentiles, which are as once born, they could be easily misused, as the temple priest misused them when at the trial of Christ Jesus, when they called him, he the king, he is another king who is establishing another kingdom, and he could not understand Pilate what they are talking about. So, but when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, but it shall be given you in that same hour what ye shall speak. Remember that in God we get the word through revelations. And when you are delivered, then you say what is in your heart. Don't twist or don't try to tell lie to defend yourself. It will go take you away from the truth. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father God which speaketh in you. And the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise against their parents and cause them to be put to death. That is what you can see these days in Mammon infested countries. Brother is no more brother, but they are only after money. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. That means when I go to churches and other things, they all, even Sikh Gurdwara temples, they all look at me as if I am a stranger and I have come to destroy their organization. And they always look with a very bad look. But I don't care, because my Father is with me. So when He is with me, you have nothing to worry. When you preach gospel, you are protected by your Father. But when you speak falsehood, then the Satan protects you. As you know, Satan has no protection. He always likes to kill you. So be honest to your Father, and he will save you. Thank